We spoke to emergency officials and they told us they received a distress call around 2:30 p.m. on Saturday. When they arrived on the scene at Gros Pitons, they found 60-year-old Christopher Dachuk, a Canadian national, on the ground.
On Saturday afternoon around 14:32 hours, we got a call for somebody in distress on Gros Pitons. Responded 1 minute after, which was 14:33. On arrival at the scene, we had to claim the piton. We got information that the person was unresponsive. On arrival at the top of the piton, the police were already on the scene. Okay, we found the patient a couple yards off track of the trail. Okay, the patient was assessed, and during the assessment, we realized there were no vital signs. Okay, also noticed that the patient was cyanotic, and also rigor mortis had already set in, okay, especially to the upper extremities, the arms and neck. Okay, and further assessment realized that the person was unresponsive.
We spoke to a taxi operator who assisted in carrying the body down the mountain. It was a tedious task, which was made a lot easier by the rapid response of the emergency team and law enforcement officials. The taxi operator told us that the visitor's bag was searched and he was found to be carrying medication for asthma. It is believed that the individual suffered an attack somewhere along the journey.
I think they should inform the guides first, because, you know, when this happened, the police checked the guy's bag and they found pills, you know, the spray for asthmatic persons. So at least they should, you know, inform us as to their medical conditions, so these things do not repeat itself.
But the Soufriere Development Foundation is concerned about the manner in which the tour was conducted. All tours of this nature, officials say, should come under the purview of the foundation. But in this instance, according to officials, they were not contacted. If a visitor is found to be suffering from a serious illness that would make such a tedious tour risky, then the foundation would advise the individual accordingly.
What I would like to state categorically, that the Soufriere Regional Development Foundation is not involved. It was not a tour conducted by us, and therefore that's the limit of what I can say on this matter.
Sometimes, according to the foundation, visitors go through what it calls the back door, and this is how it works.
I'll tell you how the back door works. Some people meet persons who may be so inclined to hike the piton, and they will go down to Assivoin Beach, avoid the interpretation center where they're met, and then tour guides and supervisors and administrative assistant would inform the person as to what to expect and what can be done.
We also received a police report on the incident.
On Saturday, March 5th, 2016, about 2:25 p.m., the Soufriere police received information that the gentleman had collapsed on the Gros Pitons trail about 2 p.m. He proceeded to the scene and ascertained the individual identity as Christopher Dachuk, a Canadian citizen, age 60. The police are now investigating the circumstances surrounding the individual death. I need to state that he was pronounced dead about 20 past 7 at the Soufriere Hospital.
Meanwhile, investigations into the incident continue. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.